It is.
It is.
Get me.
Who there below? Choppy! Choppy! Good!
Of course.
know what I mean?
Have you got all your things picked ready?
Sure. Scooby.
Crazy, man.
Then we shall leave the museum and travel by sea, train, and air, enjoying the comfort of first-class service, delightful cuisine, and a friendly smile from a tour operator. I learned from the brochure.
Yeah.
All passengers, the Transatlantic Airlines flight to Europe, please report to boarding barrier 27.
Thank you. Man, introduce myself.
Please,
Master Lander? Master Lander, indeed, madam. Come see it in this dark place and swear to my master. Rejected by my father and the victim of vengeance and hatred created by my mother. It is I who will lead you through the mists in this awaiting carriage. Come, my lady. The night draws in fast, and it is not wise to be on the road late at night. Put those bags along, scouts! Come, my lady and children. We must be a world. For this is not a place for creatures of flesh and blood. You have come to Transylvania, the edge of the world.
Too many books, and I have too much information in my epic list. Julie, you're Oh.
bold and fearless.
Yeah, is that is so.
Dr. Nick Microfiliac is his name. A brilliant young English man of medicine. He has been resident here in the Brauhaus while he continues his scientific studies at nearby Heidelberg University.
Why? He sounds too monstrous. A trainer in English too. My island's eggs escape from my brain and place of land.
Is it true what you are saying?
Indeed so. They came from the great city of Birmingham. But where does this Dr. Utah come from?
Nobody knows exactly. But we do know that he's valiant and courageous. Are you saying in the English legends, a brave from Sigalier?
Indeed, a positive action man. By there is his familiar knock, and he will be accompanied by his close friend, Barbara Stead, who sailed across the narrow sea from the mists of Ireland to be the doctor's constant companion in their fight against the black eye.
Gretel!
Huh?
Isn't that the door I'm hearing? Please open the up. Our friends will be called in fire.
Of course. What am I thinking of? It is as we anticipated. Come in, Father's Day.
Ah, Father! Doctor! It's good to see your kind and honest faces in this place again.
Indeed it is! But we have a surprise for you, my friends. The Amphibian teachers come all the way from Australia with her pupils.
I am charmed to meet you, madam. God bless you, my child. Keep you in your safe hands.
Well, I'm sure I'm very pleased to meet you, but gentlemen.
Like steel in a magnet, we have been drawn together in this town. I feel it in my very soul.
There is a time for talk, time for quiet. This is such a time. Ask just, look upon him. He's truly a man with whom a woman can feel safe. And I'm sure he's, well, qualified.
I feel breathless in this strange and total silence. I will never forget this moment when destiny has brought us together, if only for a short while. If only I could speak to her, tell her that I love her, that I worship her, that I'm well qualified.
This man is dauntless front, I recognize him all those qualities essential to the creation of White Crusader. He has my heart, for this is the first time I've ever been face to face with a positive action man.
And you must be woman!
Yeah.
dear friends. Miss Nadia, you are here for a holiday? Sightseeing, perhaps? I would venture no further from the lovely towns, Nadia. There are many superstitions appertaining to some of our castles, and it is not wise to search too deeply into their origins.
Listen now to his words, Nadia.
There are things here of which you have no knowledge.
But surely it would be foolish not to extend our knowledge of European history while residing in Transylvania.
Nadia, shall I tell you the most recent piece of history of our country? Last year, an old and revered man of our village died. It is customary here to dig the graves and roads. And as Clod, our grave digger, was preparing a new grave, he heard sounds of knocking proceeding from the very grave in which his sister had been buried but a few days previously. And knowing of my recent research into life beyond death, he called upon me. Together we called upon Father of State, who granted permission for the grave to be opened. When we returned, the cry still issued from the tomb. When we opened the coffin, we found the body of a woman, still warm, her arms and face scratched and bleeding. But here is the moment when we discovered the awful truth of the matter. On her neck, we saw the unmistakable marks of the vampire. She was possessed.
I still shudder at this tale.
Peace, peace, Robert. This was more than a year ago now, and Lord be praised with heaven.
Many whispered in the village that Count Dracula had returned to his castle, and that he and his evil mother had come once again to feed on the people of our village.
We should have no fear of him now. He has been dead some 50 years, and the castle of the Black Lake stands empty.
Dead? Or merely sleeping? Well observed, Bob. For the vampire may regain its powers if it can but obtain the life force bloody craves from one who is sufficiently pure and innocent. Father of State?
The vampire, my child, is the reanimated body of a dead person, believed to come from the grave and wander by night, sucking the person's blood of person to sleep or hypnotize, causing their death.
The vampire conceals the spilt blood of an innocent over thousands of miles, and, in the form of a bat, flies in search of his victim.
Vampire is both garlic and running water.
Glass and holy water.
The cross of our Lord. And the sharpened wooden stake, which brings everlasting death.
My dear young doctor, how rude and abrupt is is your welcome.
Not as rude and abrupt as your exit shall be, Count, if your purpose is to feed on the souls and bodies of the innocent people of this town.
Take care, my dear lady, for tonight you have the safety and protection of your inn. Another day, who knows?
Me, I'm not afraid of you.
No, I can hazard a guess. These simpletons are only here for the fear.
Fearful we may be, Count Dracula, but our belief in the church and all that stands for is enough from your powers.
Come, my friends. Do you not know that my visionary eyes can pierce through the deepest gloom of the darkest grave? And my eyes have such a vision now, but this time of beauty and light, a jewel of rare quality. Mademoiselle, I see you are a woman of some culture. You must forgive this coarseness of this riffraff, these stories of an evil reputation, about figments of their imagination.
Ah, the most charmed, Count.
Beware, Nadia!
The doctor, my dear, has never been a great admirer of me or my life's work. Which is strange, really, for you're both experts in simple surgery. It must be something of a dying art, eh, Doctor?
Inhuman phantom! Why are you here? Be about your business and leave.
Really?
Or you shall deal with me!
Such insults! They put my teeth on edge. If I could but possess some small part of the girl's belongings, some small trinket swipe now, then I can suck some of the life blood I crave, blood which is wasted in her pretty mindless body. My dear, my business is but a small proposition. I am a man of immense wealth, and would be willing to pay you handsomely if you'd be so kind as to call at my ancestral home. I have a number of daughters who are much in need of your private tuition. I will be your undying master, servant, if you be so kind as to give them some short lessons in, say, etiquette and deportment. I assure you, they are very willing pupils. I feel, with your experience, you could excite their interest and stir their blood.
Oh, you most kind, sir. We shall need some extra money for our vacation. Yes, I shall be glad to accept your kind invitation.
I shall expect you tomorrow night for dinner, then. I always have an exceptional appetite in the evening. Forgive me, my dear, a sudden illness which I suffer from time to time. I shall look forward to our first lesson tomorrow night. Farewell.
Young friends.
Good night, both.
And sleep well.
Be ill.
Doctor, I'll stand
Dracula is such a one. He seeks therefore the solitude of his castle, where he dwells alone, save for his crazed mother, the Countess Ring, and his faithful servant, Eugenius.
You seem to know an awful lot about him.
I do. My studies have convinced me that this man is truly what we have come to recognize as a vampire. There is, of course, only one sure way to cure this occult disease.
A cure? What in heaven's name?
It is too terrible to relate to such innocent ears. Come, enough of this talk. You must rest. Give me your hand.
You're very gallant, kind and gentle. Well, hush, one there. Here I'm talking away to you, and I don't even know your first name.
I hardly like to say. My name is Nicholas Orlando Erasmus Cecile Necrophiliac. I know it is a stupid and ridiculous name.
It is not at all, my heavens. What's your name? It's just a string of words. I like it for you, Agnes. Good night, Nadia.
Good night, Nadia.
Thank you.
But you work so slowly, imbecile. Can you do nothing faster? You know that tonight everything must be as we have planned.
As we have planned.
After tonight, more of my creatures will walk abroad throughout the earth. And all will acknowledge my genius. I will be master of both living and the dead.
Living and dead.
Careful, fool. Remember, I will choose carefully those of my servants who would be worthy enough to be allowed the honor of serving me through eternity.
Let me be among them, master. I will assist you in your work. I'm allowed you to find the fresh material.
Ectoplasmic Triton, have I not found the victims already? Now go off and prepare the substitute in the laboratory of the North Tower. Or it will be...
No!
The black leaf and its many scents for your deformed drunk.
No! Not the black leaf. I'll be the scroll of my fingers above my neck and the clutching knees and the brown nose of the countless victims.
Genghis.
It is not a bloody grave at the bottom of the dreaded lake.
Genghis!
Not the black lake!
Genghis!
Master?
The North Tower!
The North Tower, Master. You see, nobody understands me.
As a child, first snow.
surroundings, one must learn how to have flair, style, and sophistication. But an overpowering agent for all others who stand in your way. Don't let this tale of vanity appear as mere profanity.
Let me prepare you if I may. Can I say simply mold your education like human exploitation? And if you can't stand the test, you'll be up there with the best. Listen to a close apparatus. In your flair, style, sophistication, smart, pretty conversation. If you struggle to the top, you must let the air drop. If you wanna be a super rat like me, if you wanna be a super rat like me,
let me give you an example.
You plan a dinner at 2 or 3, a cozy bush beside the sea. This wealthy heiress you entertain with a avocado and pink champagne. So warm, romantic, and armchair. She'll come around and smuggle us back to the Chulubaloo. But please don't move. Just relieve her of her helmet and drown her in the soup. You've got to be a connoisseur of crime. You've got to be a connoisseur of crime.
I want to be a connoisseur of crime. presence, if it is she that calls.
I've had a vision. I see blood.
I make some deal. No, Flame! We must know if it is the woman I crave.
I see blood.
Welcome to my vampire empire, high upon this misty hill. Meet the intravenous genius, every second of a million thrill.
Oh, Dracula, tell me if you can, tell me if you can, tell me I love. You can keep your muscles, we can work our puzzles, tell me that's what this is there to cry.
Welcome to my band, I
bring
my farm is missing now. I supply revivification. Simply swell my name as much as you will.
You know what? what I mean?
As I feared,
This night when the children have indeed left their flock and cast themselves unwittingly into the hands of the Black Shepherd. Then we must act both quickly and without fear. Hands and proud people, round up as many of our friends as you can, and also contact this man. The information he gives us could be most vital to the success of our cause. Then, when we have assembled, we will march on the castle. The pit rock? The stake! Oh, the stake! Oh, yeah.
a master skilled in magic arts and lore. Feed us from the animal store. Prince of vampires, king of night, Dracula act of blending dynamite.
Not even beauteous frippery can hide the marble throat of this my bride. One kiss, one bite, my pretty now, and waken to ecstasy of love.
Stop! Release those children! Just in the nick of time.
How dare you enter my domain uninvited? Seize him!
No father! In the name of God, child! In heaven's name, what evil is this? Her hands come quickly. The altar clock. Take the cross and hold it. Fiends at bay.
Father?
Pray God we're not too late.
Where am I?
She's waking. Well done, O snake. Save my child. Save. Yes, my own. I'm here at your side. I'll never leave you alone again.
Oh, Nick,
would you understand?
This time it appears you have the advantage over me. Man of God and doctor of nothing. But you cannot hold us thus for much longer.
For once you alone come, Dracula. Our doctor has discovered our weakness in your armor. Now we have the opportunity to put it to the test.
salvation is over, and we must leave this dark and evil place.
Yeah, leave as quickly as possible.
I shall prepare rooms and beds for everyone at the Grand House. For tonight, we shall sleep the sleep of peace and contentment. The northern cap is no more, and the sun will shine again in Philadelphia.
You speak with the tongue of poetry and beauty, my dear Frau. Yes, the nightmare is over, and now all men can truly be free.
Thank you.
You forgot to return my card. Thank you. Come, my friends are waiting as well.
Thank you.
truly do. And do Nadia, love, Nick, truly. Then, Nick and Nadia, inasmuch as you have sworn that you love each other, truly, and have witnessed perfectly to that, I now pronounce that you are no longer two, but one in our sight, and your love.
Yeah. Slide.